Hey everybody, this is A-0085 with the TORA Media Team. Technicalities aside, we're live for the second race here at Homestead. I'm just here doing solo commentary, but... oh, we got a wreck here on the back straightaway. Alright, looks like Race Boy 77 took some damage on the front bumper. Alright, we have a battle for second place between LMR DarthMario and second up runner. That'd be Sprint Car 92K. Coming down the back straightaway, heading towards turn 3 and 4. They're still side by side coming towards turn 3. DarthMario's gonna hold the inside line and roll and reclaim second place. And we have a battle between 4th and 5th. That's gonna be Raceboy 77 and HCR Noodle. And we see 13th place, that would be Windcharger, coming back onto the track. He has made his first early pit stop here on the 50-lapper. Still side-by-side, DarthMario on the outside. They make a little bit of contact coming towards turn 3. DarthMario's going to hold the outside line, going up into first. Raceboy has now moved up into 4th place. And behind them, we have a battle for 5th, 6th, 7th, and 8th. Bobo the Clown has just gone up high through turn 2 on the back straightaway. Looks like he's going to draft off Race Boy. And there's a 3-way coming down towards into turn 3, which is now broken into a 2-way. Hi folks, thanks for tuning in. The Twitch app has just reloaded the viewer count. Alright, you have not missed much in the second half here at Homestead. And hopefully you guys can hear me. If you guys can hear me, just let me know in the chat so this way I can verify that the mic is working. Oh, and something has happened to Sprint Car. He just hit the guardrail coming towards the start-finish line, and that's a disconnect. We're now down to 12 drivers. This will put Raceboy 77 into the top three. Fortunately, first place has already gained an advantage on second place, DarthMario. Hey there, DW Kite. Welcome to the stream. Hopefully you can hear me. Alright, as we continue on through the field, looks like we have an upcoming battle from 8th to 10th place. We have Midland Zeta, Radiation Lewis, and Iceman. And coming up down on the inside is Big Ben 0913 going into turn one. He moves into ninth place, dropping Radiation Lewis down to 10th. Ben driving the number 213 Caterpillar. Thanks for verifying, guys. I was worried because the Twitch app here on the Xbox One is very fickle with the mic. Alright. Let's continue on with the action, shall we? And yes, the comms booth is pretty lonely up here. Oh, and Ben goes high up on through turn two, taking the outside line. This is going to allow Radiation Lewis to catch right up into the draft zone, coming down towards turn three. Lewis is going to go on the inside, but Ben is going to go defensive, coming down through turn four. He goes high up on the banking. And Radiation Lewis is going to hug the inside, and he's going to go straight forward and take ninth place away from Ben. All right, we're almost halfway done here for the second half of Homestead. And right behind is Windcharger 8199, currently in 12th place. If Windcharger can catch into the draft of Big Ben, both of them can slingshot right behind Radiation Lewis for 9th place. Lewis will be catching up to Midland Zeta in just a few moments. Raceboy 77 is your leader, followed by LMR DarthMario in 2nd place. There are currently 1 drop due to a lobby disconnect, and we're currently at 12 drivers. Oh, Ben goes over the line, coming out of turn two, trying to avoid hitting Radiation Lewis. If I remember correctly, for Motegi, which was, I believe, 2014, 2015, there were about 8 or 10 of you guys. Anyways. And 7th place has come into pit road. That'll be Midland Zeta. And by the sound of slowing down by Bobo the Clown. As a gear shift, that's going to allow Iceman to pass for 4th place. Alright, we're now past the halfway marker here for the second stint of the Homestead. And I do apologize for my commentary, it's been a while since I've done solo commentary. And just a lot of technicalities coming through. As we watch both 4th and 5th place getting by lap traffic, LMR DarthMario has gained the lead here at Homestead. It definitely sounds like there's something wrong with Bobo the Clown's car as I hear a huge decrease in acceleration. Iceman is now coming down to pit road for his pit stop. So Midland Zeta is currently leading. As we continue to watch the ticker go by up on the top of the screen. And Midland Zeta's coming in for his pit stop. Alright, Bobo the Clown will be leading the pack. Alright, Bobo the Clown up in front, both 8th and 9th place are going to be duking out here crossing the start finish line, and then we see 10th place coming up on the horizon. That'll be Wind Charger 8199. With Bobo in front of these two, this is going to be beneficial for Windcharger. However, Iceman is going to go on the offensive, hugging on the outside down the back straightaway, and Bobo the Clown's going to let him go. Radiation Lewis is going to follow in the draft on the high banking up through turn three. Fifteen laps to go here for the second stint at Homestead. Currently, it's Bobo the Clown still in first place. Oh, and there goes Iceman. He got loose coming out of the banking on turn four, and this is going to allow Radiation Lewis to slingshot by, passing the star finish line, going towards turn one, side by side. Lewis on the inside, Iceman on the outside. And Radiation Lewis gets seventh place from Iceman. Our Iceman is caught up into the draft of Radiation Lewis. Let's see if he's going to try the over and under. Lewis on the inside, hugging it tight, coming out of turn four. And we see sixth place, right up in front. It's going to be Midland Zeta. Alright, looks like there might be some issues there with Midland Zeta as Radiation Lewis is caught up into the draft with Iceman in tow. There's single file coming down through turn three, going into turn four. And they're going to come down side by side. Radiation Lewis gets by Midland Zeta, followed by Iceman. And a little bump draft right there going into turn one. Windcharger is going to need a miracle to catch up to these three as they come down onto the back straightaway. Oh, we got a wreck coming down to turn three. Radiation Lewis and Midland Zeta make contact, and Lewis hits the tire barrier. Looks like that was lag that caused the incident. This is going to drop Zeta down to 10th place, and I think I hear the sound of a yellow flag coming out. Alright, yellow flag is out here for the second stint with 10 laps to go. Bobo the Clown currently leads the field. If anyone needs to make a pit stop, now would be the time. And if I remember my NASCAR terminology, Ben gets the lucky dog pass. We have the top five currently single file as we complete our first caution lap. And the tail end of the field has caught up with the top five coming down to turn three. I sense we're going to be going green very shortly. Bubba the Clown is coming in for his first pit stop, which means LMR DarthMario will gain the lead. Actually, it'll be WRA Tower. No, it's actually going to be Mario. Alright, hopefully we can figure out the running order here in just a moment as they try to get the grid order here. Looks like it might be a double file restart. Eight laps to go here for the second stint at Homestead. Who's going to take the win? Who's going to cause the big one? And who's going to be the next lucky dog? Let's find out. Double file, and green flag is out for the last seven laps here at Homestead for the second stint. DarthMario is going to be side by side with WRA Tower going into turn one. And there's a three-way battle in the mid-pack. DarthMario is going to hug to the inside, try to keep on the draft of WRA Tower, who's currently leading. Oh, but we got a great battle going on from fourth to fifth. Let's go check it out. So Marcuse is currently on the inside, trying to hold on to fourth place. He's dropping to fifth, however the draft is going to be favoring the inside. And Windcharger is going to move into fourth place! He might be able to get third. Coming down to turn one, Marcuse is going to hold on to fifth. And here comes Windcharger on the inside, he's going high! Marcuse is going to bump draft him three wide, going down in the back straightaway. Windcharger's gonna have some patience here if he's gonna try to hold on to the lead. It looks like there's smoke up in the front. Oh, and that's DarthMario! And we have a spin. But will be enough to cause a caution. And the unfortunate victim of that accident is Iceman412, as well as Bubba the Clown. DarthMario's currently in 10th place. Alright, let's take a look at the front and see if we have caution. Caution is out, with five laps to go. WRA Tower leads with ACR Noodle in third, French Cuban Bread in... it's Tower, Noodle, French Cuban Bread, then Windcharger. And it looks like we're going to do a double file restart. Everyone has caught back up, exiting out of turn four. Green flag's gonna be waving in just a moment. And here we go with four laps left here at the second stint of Homestead. All right, and it looks like Windcharger is gonna go for the dodge maneuver. He's gonna take the high line coming into turn one. Tower leads. Fresh Cuban Bread has gained second place. Coming down to the back straightaway. Up, here comes Noodle, followed by Marcuse in fourth place. Fresh Cuban Bread has now moved into third. Windcharger is being pushed high up. Coming through turn four, he's going to be dropping down to sixth place. It's going to be a mad scramble with three laps to go. Tower, Noodle, and Cuban Bread are your top three. And right behind is Race Boy in fourth place. Harvey's going to have to deal with Marcuse, who's right behind, followed by Windcharger. Marcuse has the high line. Focusing on 6th place, LMR DarthMario has moved into 8th. He might be able to drop off of Windcharger, who's currently in 6th, and he does! Moving ahead of Radiation Lewis, Windcharger's gonna dive down on the inside towards turn 3, going into turn 4. Darth Mario's pushed up high, coming out of turn 4 with Radiation Lewis right behind, and the rest of the pack. Alright folks, we're down to the last two laps here for the second stint at Homestead. Windcharger has a flurry of stock cars right behind. And Darth Mario's slingshot's coming out of turn 2. Windcharger's gonna have the outside line. Darth Mario's gonna hold it on the inside, coming down side by side. They almost make contact coming towards turn 3. 1.5 laps to go here at Homestead. White flag is out, 1 lap to go. Radiation Lewis has passed Windcharger. Darth Mario has passed Windcharger. And it looks like Boba the Clown is gonna make the pass on Windcharger as well. This is gonna push Windcharger back to 9th place. Making his way down through turn 3 and turn 4. Checker flag will be waving for the second stint. And the winner of stint 2 is going to go to WRA Tower. Second place will be Noodle. Alright, that concludes the second stint. Let's see if I can actually get some people in here. Hi. If anybody can hear me, I'm going to have a party open again so we can do some driver interviews. Hey, Windcharger, I got a party open if you want to do some commentary quick. I'm streaming. Alright, I kind of sent out a couple of messages to people if they'd like to join for a little bit of commentary, since I have a party up. I swear I'm gonna kill my phone. Alright, judging by the no response I'm getting from anybody, I don't think we're gonna have commentary. Maybe after. Alright, I think this is the last stint. Alright, doing the warm-up lap. Let's see where everyone's gonna fan out here. WRA Tower is gonna lead up in front with HDR Noble in second. Race Boy 77 will be in third. Fourth will be Fresh Cuban Bread. Actually, it looks like everyone's still trying to get organized. Alright, so we have WRA Tower, Noodle, Fresh Cuban Bread. Marcus, DarthMario. Clown, Radiation Lewis. Green flag is out, and we're live for the third stint here at Homestead. Tower's gonna get first place, followed by Noodle in second. Coming down to turn one, the pack goes 2-3 wide. and for a second I thought I saw a spin in the middle of the pack. Must have been lag. Raceboy77 has moved into third place. The Fresh Cuban Bread in fourth, and DarthMario in fifth. And their single file coming down to turn three. Battle for a second between Noodle and Raceboy. Coming down to turn one, Raceboy's gonna be on the outside. He dives back in to follow the draft of Noodle, who's currently in second place. First through fifth has already pulled ahead from sixth and back. Four laps to go here for this stint at Homestead. Noodle's gonna go high going into turn two. This will be beneficial for Raceboy as Cuban Bread and DarthMario are right behind, respectively, in fourth and fifth place. Gonna go on board with Fresh Cuban Bread as he's drafting off of Raceboy77, who's currently in third place. Side by side, Noodle's gonna be on the outside, Raceboy is on the inside with nobody to give him any bumping. Going down to turn one, Raceboy's gonna draft off of Noodle. Noodle's gonna go high coming into turn two. Raceboy's gonna hug the inside line. He's gonna file right back in behind Noodle, going down the back straightaway. Oh, Noodle gets a little loose coming out of turn four, but Raceboy does not have the momentum to get by him. This is gonna be good for Fresh Cuban Bread. And he's gonna make the pass going down to turn one. However, right behind is LMR DarthMario. Cuban Bread hugging the inside, coming down the back straightaway. Oops, side by side, Cuban Bread's gonna move into third place, and Raceboy is gonna fall back to fourth. Or will he regain that position coming down through turn three and turn four? DarthMario is right behind Raceboy77. However, he switched lanes. Who is he gonna draft off of, I wonder? 40 laps to go here at Homestead. And DarthMario has picked Raceboy77 to draft off of. This is looking good for him. He's going to be able to hold on to that position. DarthMario's now caught up to Cuban Bread. All three are pretty close coming down to turn three. WRA Tower still leads, with Noodle in second place. Ooh, Raceboy almost clipped the wall going into turn four. And DarthMario's gonna try to pass both of them on the inside, going into turn one, and he does it! DarthMario has moved into third place. Cuban Bread fourth, and contact between Raceboy and Cuban Bread. And that's gonna signal, I believe, a caution. There is no caution, they're still gonna race to the line. Sprint car. Nope, that was Bobo the Clown coming out of pit road for his pit stop. Marcus is caught up in fifth place, and it looks like he'll be working on Fresh Cuban Bread. As Cuban Bread makes his way past Bobo the Clown, nope, he's gonna get cut off there. And there goes Marcus drifting off through turn one. That's gonna allow Radiation Lewis, who's currently right behind, to catch up. Lewis has moved into fifth place. Midland Zeta is now in 6th, and Marcus has dropped to 7th place. Alright, it's getting really interesting, folks, with only 34 laps to go. And who do I see in 8th place? That'll be Iceman. And he's gonna challenge Marcus for 7th place. Iceman holds the inside line coming down the back straightaway. He's gonna be cutting the gap here on Marcus coming down to turn 3. Iceman's gonna get the 7th spot away from Marcus. And Bubba the Clown's causing some problems, which I believe is for 9th place. And Marcus is not gonna give up that position to Iceman coming down into turn 1. Side by side, Iceman's gonna be on the outside. He's gonna try a crossover on the inside. He backs off, coming down to the back straightaway. Looks like Radiation Lewis is being challenged by Midland Zeta. Lewis currently in 5th place with Zeta in 6th. Coming down the start-finish line is going to be Lewis followed by Midland Zeta. Going down to turn 1, Zeta is going to hug the inside line. Lewis is starting to drift upwards coming into turn 2. And here goes Midland Zeta. Is he going to have enough momentum to make the pass on Lewis? No, he does not. Right behind Midland Zeta is Marcus in 7th place. We have a battle for 5th to 7th. And the battle has changed for 6th and 7th between Midland Zeta and Marcus. See some smoke from the back of Radiation Lewis coming down through turn 4, hitting up the high banking towards the start-finish line. And we see the lap traffic of Bobo the Clown in 11th place. Battle shaping up between 5th through 8th. Exiting out of turn 4, Sir Marcus currently is trying to find some way to pass Midland Zeta. And Iceman is right behind Marcus. Oh, Midland Zeta makes contact with Marcus. He's going to lose 2 positions. And here goes Iceman for 5th place. And Windcharger has now moved into 8th place, followed by Big Ben 0913 in 9th. Iceman is going to be hunting down Radiation Lewis for 4th place, coming down to turn 3. However, he has 6th and 7th right behind him. If they can stick together, they might be able to catch up to Lewis. With only 28 laps to go, who's gonna get it? 12th place is now gone to the draft, that is Sprint Car 29K. Looking at the battle from 8th and 9th, Raceboy 77 is caught up with these two, and he's trying to cut his way through. Passes Windcharger. Windcharger is going to hopefully try to keep up with them. Raceboy on the outside, going through turn 3 into turn 4. Big Ben on the inside, looks like Windcharger is going to use the draft off of Raceboy to slingshot by. Crossing the start-finish line, Big Ben and Windcharger are side-by-side going into turn 1. This is going to be a battle for 8th place. Coming down the back straightaway, Big Ben on the outside, Windcharger coming back into the draft. Ben is high, Windcharger is low, coming down past turn 4. And we see 7th has come in for their pit stop, that would be Sir Marcus. We are halfway through Stint 3 here at Homestead. ACR Noodle is leading the pack, as cars continue to cycle through pit stops. And Noodle's going to be working on 9th place. That's going to be our own LMR DarthMario. Midland Zeta has come out of pit road and is currently in 9th place. Windcharger has made the pass on Big Ben for 5th, and he's passed Fresh Cuban Bread. That can only mean... Big Ben has exited out of pit road and is now dropped to last place. Windcharger has now moved into the top 3. This is looking good for the number 81 Valvoline. With only 21 laps to go, will Windcharger hold on to the top 3? Will he have to make a pit stop? Will there be a caution? This is also looking good for Radiation Lewis, who's currently in 2nd place. However, he's being challenged by Sprint Car 29K. Sprint Car is currently almost a lap down. And Radiation Lewis is coming into pit. This will bump Windcharger up into 2nd place. Nineteen laps to go. And right behind Windcharger is Big Ben, who is in last place. DarthMario has moved into fourth place. Fifteen laps to go here at Homestead. HDR Noodle leads with Windcharger in second place, followed by WRA Tower in third, and LMR DarthMario in fourth place. Speaking of DarthMario, there he is right now. HDR Noodle's going to be working his way on him very shortly. It looks like some competition will be heating up between 5th and 6th place. Sprint Car 29K in 6th, and Fresh Cuban Bread in 5th. Twelve laps to go. Cuban Bread kissed the wall there on turn 4. This is looking good for Sprint Car 29K, who's about to catch up to him. Ten laps to go. And it looks like we're going to have a battle from 8th to 10th place between Radiation Lewis Iceman and Sir Marcus, with Midland Zeta in 11th. And we have a spin! It's going to be Iceman Sir Marcus on turn 1. Iceman has just recovered and he's back on the track. However, will that be enough to cause a yellow? HDR Noodles come into pit road. Which means the leader is going to be switching to Windcharger 8199, with Big Ben right behind. Caution is out. Windcharger leads. And the lucky dog is going to hopefully go to Big Bend. 8 laps to go. Can Windcharger hold the lead? Has he even made a pit stop for all that I know? Here comes HCR Noodle, and we'll be seeing LMR DarthMario. And Big Ben gets the lucky dog, he's going to be coming back onto the lead lap. Seven laps to go, Windcharger leads with HCR Noodle in second, and then we'll be seeing LMR DarthMario in third place. I'm sure the pressure is on for Windcharger, as he has 7 laps to hold his lead. He has more experienced drivers in TORA who will be right behind him very soon. If Windcharger can get this, this will be his first live stream broadcast here at TASCAR. And third and fourth place have caught up. WRA Towers moved back into third with DarthMario in fourth. Looks like the field is still organizing and they might be doing a single file restart. And Windcharger has come in for his pit stop. Unfortunately, this will change the positions around. WRA Tower is going to reclaim first place. Or will be DarthMario. 6 laps to go. Everyone's going to be double file for this restart. Windcharger has exited out of pit road, and he will be making his way up to the field in just a moment. And we just got word Windcharger has caught up with the pack. Sprint car 29K is currently down past the banking here. 6 laps to go. All or nothing. Will WRA Tower take another win? Will DarthMario clinch the win? Will there be another wreck? One more caution. I guess Sprint Car did not come in for his pit stop. Whew, this is very tense right now, folks. I kid you not. All cars are bunched up double file. They're making their way out of turn 4. Will this be it? Will this be the green flag? Green flag is out, and here we go! WRA Tower gets a great start, and he's going to hold on to first place with DarthMario in second, and Fresh Human Bread in third, coming down towards turn 1. It's going to be a battle for second. Fresh Human Bread has it. And my screen's loading. Come on, screen. Let's do this. Oh, looks like there was a bit of a slip-up! DarthMario slingshots by for the lead! Pack is slowing down, looks like there was a wreck. And the victims were Race Boy, Windcharger, and Iceman 412. All right, with 3 laps to go, they're going to be probably calling in for a green-white checker. WRA Tower is in first place with Cuban Bread second, Darth Mario in third. And Bobo the Clown has moved back up into fourth. Radiation Lewis in sixth. It's getting really dicey here. 2.5 laps to go, jeez. And here we go again for the second time for a green flag. WRA Tower gets first with Fresh Cuban Bread right behind in second place. Third is going to be contested with LMR DarthMario. Now we see one of the other. We see someone moving fast up on the outside banking. Oh, and Wind Charger clips the wall! Some of the traffic has bounced back with 2 laps to go. It's gonna be very close here from 4th onward. Radiation Lewis is under pressure. And here comes a cargo line. That's gonna be Sprint Car 29K moving up into the top 5. All right, folks, white flag is out, 1 lap to go. WRA Tower is in first place with Cuban Brand second and Darth Mario in third. We're gonna focus on second place. Sprint Car has moved up into fourth with Radiation Lewis in fifth. There's a 3-way going on in the back. Checker flag is going to be waving for WRA Tower with Fresh Cuban Bread in second and Darth Mario in third. Fourth is going to go to Race Boy. That was crazy. Sounds like an issue with Microsoft. Nice. So was this the last one, or you guys still have one more? Alright, if you guys want, I have a party up for like post-race interviews. Hehe. Alright, yeah, my party's up. Oh. Do you want me to join you guys instead? Thank you. All right, folks. That was the last 50 laps here at Homestead. I'm going to see if I can try to get some interviews while we're still live streaming, which would be awesome. Sorry, I was in party chat. What's up? Alright, I think you guys have it set to invite only. Ugh. Well, shoot. Yeah. The thing is, I don't think it will be able to stream you guys in the lobby chat. It'll have to be directly to party for it to work. Yeah, mine has invites. Let me invite you first, since I imagine you have everybody on your list. Show gamer card, and then I'll invite you. Alright, I'll see you in party chat. Alright, we finally got somebody to interview. Hopefully he can hear us. Go to, I believe, party settings, and there should be a checkbox that'll allow you to enable your party chat to be heard.
Go, I got it now.
All right, I'm here with WRA Tower, who just dominated the past three races. Welcome.
Hey.
So, how's it feel winning here at Homestead?
It's pretty awesome, man. It was the second win of the season. I won Indy, and then I came here to win. I really needed it. I was 3 points out of the Privateer Championship behind Zeta, and I needed the win just to kind of cement the championship for me. Managed to get it, and heart kind of went up in my throat there with 10 to go. We had that late caution with 10 to go, and Zeta was coming up through the pack, and I thought for sure he was going to get close enough to where I wasn't going to be able to get it, but. Managed to hold him off in the end, won all three stints, and took the overall race win tonight. Pretty happy about it, pretty excited.
It looked like you had a very strong Chevy tonight, I noticed.
Yeah, I mean, it was four stock. You know, I'm old NASCAR guy, and I've always ran ovals. They pretty much hand it to me on the road courses, but once we get on the ovals, that's where I can kind of take over there. Yeah. So.
Yeah. Unfortunately,
pretty happy about it.
Oh, sorry. Actually, I was going to say, I actually have not been keeping up with TASCAR due to how hectic my life has been, so this is the first TASCAR event I've been able to actually stream and commentate for you guys.
Yeah. Well, that's cool. We appreciate it. At least you got to do it on the championship, you know, for the final race. That's good.
Yeah, I'm like,
Cuban Bread pretty much dominated the season. LMR Hybrid came in and kind of sniped a couple races. I think he won Laguna Seca, and I want to say he won at Coda. But outside of that, I mean, Cuban Bread's really dominated the whole season, just win after win after win. You know, I think Raceboy might have got a win. I think Raceboy won at VIR, if I remember correctly. But, I mean, Cuban's really been the dominant driver all season, and the rest of us just kind of been chasing him around.
Well, he definitely put up a great show with you guys.
Yeah. Yeah, he managed to, he had a little bit of an issue there in the first stint, and he kind of fell back through the pack, but he managed to drive his way back up through there and finish second in the race tonight, which was, you know, he really needed that to cement the team championship, I believe.
Now, is this your first time participating in TASCAR?
Yeah, it is, actually. It's really the first time I've participated in a full TORA season, to be honest with you. I've nice. Dabbled in it here and there. I kind of ran Daytona in the TEC, but my work schedule really doesn't make it conducive for me to run weekly series, but this one just happened to be on Saturday night, so I decided to go ahead and give it a shot. I missed two races. I missed both Daytona races due to work, but still managed to get a sub for the second one. I had, who did sub for me? Broomski sub for me in the second one, and he got me the points I needed, and managed to pull off a privateer championship in my first full TORA season, first full TASCAR season, so I'm pretty happy.
Is there anybody you want to say thanks to or a special shout out while we're here?
Everybody on AX4X, Fresh Cuban Bread, Big Ben, and them guys, you know, they did a lot of tuning during the season when I was working 80, 90 hours a week and really couldn't do it. I mean, they did a lot of the tuning and they did a really good job. So yeah, just everybody on AX4X, Cuban Bread, Big Ben, all those guys, you know. So, outside of and that, I'm just going to hang out. I know.
Well, I also know that there's some news as well, but I'm going to save that for the very end once interviews have passed. So thank you very much for copping into the comms booth, and congratulations again.
Yeah, man. Thank you. No problem.
All right. Let's see what else I can
You have
bring
a good
in
evening,
here.
Man.
Thank you very much, Tower.
Get them guys in here. No problem, buddy.
All right. That was WRA Tower winning 3 times here and also his first TASCAR series. While we continue to try to harass other people to get into the party, let's see who else we got. Send out them invites faster than you can count. Looks like Cuban Bread has left the lobby. Shucks.
I'm sending him a message for you right now to see if I can get him to jump into your party chat.
Ah, thank you. I will also invite DarthMario, because I feel that is very important. Hello, hello. All right, you should have an option to checkbox so you can have your party chat audio heard. Hey, Cuban.
Hello. There we go. I included it.
All right. As soon as you both have the checkbox set, then we'll continue the next round of interviews.
Oh, okay. I didn't expect that. Okay.
Oh my. This party is starting to get pretty hectic here. You're perfectly fine. This is the post race show.
He could be the team owner. He could accept that speech. That's all true.
Right. I'll see if I can bring one more guest in here in just a moment. Because that's important.
Thanks, Ben, for the job. Really appreciate it. Two shiny trophies. Actually, I keep one, but still.
All right, folks, we're going to be having one more guest with us in the comms booth momentarily. So, for those who are wondering, we have Big Ben 0913, Fresh Cuban Bread, the unstoppable TASCAR driver, and our host of TASCAR, LMR DarthMario.
Heyo.
So, yeah, tonight was pretty intense for all three stints. Did not expect there to be a green-white checker near the end. How do you guys feel?
Exhausted.
I was not looking forward to that restart, or the last two restarts, rather.
Mm-hmm.
I had to sit on a kiddie chair today, because my normal sim rig isn't here. He did, it was hilarious. So,
he was cute.
Oh, I'm probably going to get a bunch of crow now in the group chat, because they always make short jokes, so that's going to be fun.
Yes, prepare thyself.
And it looks like we have another guest coming into the party chat. That would be XB6 Broomski, and some other people as well.
Okay, you might need to lock the party.
Yeah, I think
you might want to lock the party.
This is the post-race show, Broom. On the live stream, so. Yes, please. Okay, yeah, go ahead. You're live on air.
Thank you.
Thank you, Broom.
All right, I'm going to get to the meat of the issue here. We're going to get right to Darth Mario time. So, you've been hosting TASCAR for a long, long time here at TORA. And I'm sure you have some news to share as well for those who have not been keeping an eye on Facebook and the forums.
Well, I guess you're aiming at the new coordinator?
That as well. Do you want me to say it, or did you want to?
No, I just wanted to make sure what I needed to cover. and I announced it in the race lobby at the end of the petite TASCAR round at Road Atlanta. I mentioned that Jay Groves is going to be taking over my position as TASCAR coordinator.
Yeah, it's definitely shocker of a news hearing about you stepping down from TASCAR and a little bit of TORA activity for the time being. You're definitely going to be missed.
Yeah, more than I thought. Yeah. The guys on staff were telling me some pretty nice, were giving me some nice words. It's I honestly wasn't expecting that.
Yeah, well you will be missed.
And the fact that you're able to bring an American racing series to where it is now here, where mostly it's UK races. So that's definitely something in itself. And you managed to, from the TORA Stock Car series, if I'm not mistaken, from circa 2010, and then managed to take over from there, correct?
That one wasn't exactly mine, but when I took over, I renamed it TASCAR.
Actually, it's funny, I did have a car set up for Forza 4, unfortunately my work schedule did not allow that, so... Oh well.
Yeah, I think the series, time-wise, started on Forza 3. Back then we actually had the Dodge, but then with Forza 4, they somehow eliminated it.
Yeah, it was kind of like with the Touring and Meisterschaft cars. It's like, oh yeah, we have Audi and Mercedes, and then they threw in Opel and another TT. Anyways, we also have a last-minute guest who just entered the comms booth, Windcharger8199, who had a momentary spotlight up in front, and then he had to make a pit stop.
Yeah, I was really hoping that, to be honest, if... It's so close on fuel, but I was like, well, I have to anyway, so I could have won the first. I mean, if she, I wish I could have won it, to be honest with you, but I mean, car was okay, not fast. But
now, hey. I noticed that you had a bit of an incident after the first restart. Can you explain what happened there?
I just had nowhere to go. Iceman, I guess he touched the apron, something spun around, and I was up on the high side trying to make some time, and he came right up in front of me and just nowhere to go. I ran right into him.
I was actually rooting for you a little bit there. I'm like, oh man, he's gonna win! And then that happened.
I will give a shout out to AC Noodle. He, if he would have timed that perfect, his last pit stop perfectly, he would have actually, he would have probably won the race, but
he, yeah, he had, you two had me nervous up front
right before hit, so I could have made it had I had, I had like 6,000 feet on U Tower, but if, but I only had like 1,900 feet, so I couldn't do the whole clutch and coast and all that, because somehow that don't work properly. No sense to me.
All right. Well, gonna pass this along real quick. For everybody here, is there any shout-outs or special thanks you want to give to the audience, or just for whatever reason?
I'll say something. I just shout out to thank Mark for
making an awesome series.
Yes, yeah, shout out to Mark.
Sorry.
I was going to say thank you for everyone participating in TASCAR, making it as popular as it is. And I hope it's just as popular next year with the Jordan at the helm.
Outsourcing.
Well, don't start back, back
to try to defend my privateer championship. So.
And it's a shame that... I will make this announcement. I will be full-time next year at TASCAR for my first, for my rookie year. I only ran three races this year, so next year, rookie year in TASCAR. And hopefully a rookie of the year standings calculations in order too, so.
That would be cool, yeah.
Unfortunately, my schedule does not allow me to participate in a majority of TORA races, so this is probably the best I can do to help you guys.
I would like to make an announcement as well.
Go for it, Cuban.
It's been fun, you know, and... But yeah, Mario, do you have any... Do you have an extra seat? Because next season, I more than, like... Actually, somewhere, like, it's pretty much... Yeah, I won't be returning due to Team Gearhead planning on doing other projects on TORA, and they're going to need me more there. So, yeah, it's one and done. I'm going to Rosberg it. And yeah, it was fun. It was fun. I mean, this year was good overall. You know, it had a really, really bright little bit, and then
mistaken,
it got raving.
You had some pretty good success in IndyCar, right?
Yeah, I was actually gonna get to that. I'm just an open wheel racer, man. I'm these
okay.
Heavy bricks.
Yeah, I expect it's a really stiff competition after what was it? I was the. What, the pace car for this year's Indy 500?
Yeah, I believe so.
Mm-hmm.
And I was there watching a little bit of it, and...
Yeah, and it was actually Tyra and I battling there as well. But yeah, I'm gonna Rosberg. It was great, you know, and I wish, you know, the next group of management the very best, but... Yeah, I'm pretty much signing out, and... It's been a good year overall for the team in general, because it started with a really bright moment with Daytona, and it very quickly got dark, and lots of changes, lots of stuff. I joined AX4X middle of the year, and I didn't know, well, I did have somewhat of an idea of what I wanted to do, and for me it was going to be like a multi-year thing. I didn't expect it to be this quickly, but I mean, that'd say something, you know, about this team, and you know, it needed that extra little push, and I'm glad that I was that little push, and yeah, in TASCAR it was great, 3 wins, you know, consistency, making every race, and along with IndyCar as well, that was pretty good as well, and yeah, so I can confirm next year we'll be doing IndyCar, that for sure, because I'm an open wheel guy through and through, and I can't go without doing that. And then another unannounced project, which I don't think, because if I say it, I think Ben's going to shoot me, but...
I will.
and not probably Mark, too, because until... And, as of right now, he's still staff, so...
Yes, so I can't say the other thing Team Gearhead's going to be involved with, but I will say, yeah, we will be in there as well. but yeah... We'll see. But yeah, thanks to Fly Mikey J for giving me this wonderful opportunity. Ben as well, he's a co-owner. You know, thank you, man. Thank you for giving me a job so I don't have to be at the soup kitchen. I'd like to congratulate Mario. I'd like to congratulate Mario, you know, on many successful years of running the series. Hopefully Jay Gross can really do well, all outsourcing jokes aside. And congratulate Tower for
Thank
Privateer.
You,
he made a mid-season sign with us, and we're very glad to have helped you out to.
I appreciate all the help to get
the championship. Yeah, no problem, man. And hopefully we could see you next year in here as well. So.
I plan on trying to defend the Privateer Championship that is on the board for me, among at least one other series I'm going to probably attempt to do.
So. Yep. But yeah, so Mario, if you have an extra seat, just give me the ticket now, and I'll see you at the airport in about an hour or two. Actually, no, I'm in Miami. I'll just go home then. Oh, have fun in your country. Why would I want to go back to Indianapolis? Oh, right, IndyCar. But well
IndyCar. Yeah.
You want to go home and kiss the brick. That's what you want to do.
Yeah.
I already kissed him twice. Actually, hopefully a third time.
I'm gonna give you a hell of a run for that Indy 500 next time around too. Don't think I'm not gonna be right on your bumper like I was last time. So
yeah, and hopefully Airwash actually plays in your favor, because last time was just ridiculous.
It was atrocious. Yeah, and I got caught between two lappers. Nightmares again. I had nightmares over that.
Triggered. Anyway.
Yeah.
That's the team owner. Well, Ben, I thought Ben was going to start with that.
No. I don't feel like I really need to say anything, because we had a really good team this year. We got you to sign on with us, begrudgingly, probably. And then halfway through the series, Raceboy said, "Hey, I want to do TASCAR. Can you give me a seat?" Well, all drama aside, that was a pretty good decision. So, yeah. This is technically my first TASCAR season, so I'm excited to come away with a team's championship in my first attempt, I guess I can say, even though I kind of rode on everyone else's coattails the entire time.
Yeah, it's all right.
That's what being a team is about.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you're the one that has to pay for the gift basket to Raceway.
Yeah.
And speaking of IndyCar, Mr. Lewis Satterley has joined us here today.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my, the party has just gotten a heck of a lot bigger.
And I'm pretty sure the beans have been spilled, and I think he could probably tell us a little thing about his team for next season.
Well, once his mic has been checked and we can hear him broadcasting, then we'll have the Lewis Hour. Well, we've been going for almost about 20-30 minutes now, so you could be the last half of the hour.
Budget cuts.
Hundred plus, yep.
Guys can't tell.
Yeah. Well, Lewis. We were just talking about IndyCar in a TASCAR interview.
Actually, I was going to go on a. Well, actually, Liz, since you're in the chat, quick.
Hitch.
It's good.
How did you feel
it.
Your? I'm talking.
Oh, Lewis, check your mic. They can't hear you on the stream.
Oh.
Make sure you check the little Xbox thing. The check the include my audio thing.
It'll be in party settings, in party and there should be a checkbox.
There we go.
You gotta now you get to repeat everything you just said. Awesome.
You get to be sentimental. Come on.
Basically, he's gonna miss Mark and watch this space, and that's it.
Yeah, that's pretty much what I said. Bottom of my heart, thank you to Mark for everything when it came down to the dark ages of TORA all the way to now. So, big thank you.
And thank you, Lewis.
Now we
and
have
thank, a... thank you to everybody that's in this little chat.
Thank you, man. I got two more ribbons.
A pleasure racing for you.
I was actually going to ask Lewis real quick, since we were talking about TASCAR. You definitely had some interesting battles for the second and last stint up in the top five. How'd you feel about that?
To be honest with you, I was not even expecting to be anywhere near the top five. Be honest with you, I was surprised I even found myself in A lobby to begin with, because, I mean, ovals are just not my strong suit at all. Never really been strong on them, even with setups or without setups, regardless of the car. So to find myself in A lobby to begin with, you know, and I was only expecting to be pounding around in the back, and then somewhere I seem to have found the right way to drive the car around the track or something, because it just seemed to keep working and kept creeping up. So almost got the career best finish on an oval, but ended up tying my career best. So is what it is.
Anybody in particular you want to say a special shout out to or a thank you?
Well, I'd like to thank my mom, you know, because she put me here. And
I can do that. Well, I'm gonna sleep in the dark.
And if I go total Peter Griffin here, I'm gonna have to say I'd like to thank God. You know, you make the world go around. Right.
He's trying to do an impersonation here. Let him do it.
Yeah. Yeah,
no,
that didn't
No.
Oh, you want me to do Cleveland again? Okay.
Oh, Jesus. He's even trying very hard.
I can do Cleveland pretty good, so don't even try me there.
Oh, what the hell?
What the hell? Anyway.
This turned this into a Family Guy.
It's the Cleveland hour.
Epic. Epic.
Post-race interviews. What else you got to talk about? Family Guy impressions.
Well, let's try to keep on the topic here. We're actually losing viewers.
Nothing but
ADD.
The most professional content here from TORA.
And not exactly for other podcasting with my usual two tryhards. What? I'm part of the tryhard commentary. Sorry. I don't really have anything else.
Three!
Actually, since you're the interviewer, I'm gonna flip the table on you. So how was the race from your perspective?
Okay.
What did you see? What did you study anything? Tire wear, fuel wear, you know, like different line tires are using.
All right. The first thing I'm gonna point out is this is the first time I've gotten the update for the ticker, so I am used to cycling through the grid to find out where everybody is. That was definitely something new. And I was also fumbling over my words like usual. But at least we're at an oval track, so I could be forgiven! Racing-wise, it was all over the place. I tried covering as much screen time with you guys as I could. There were some instances where I was sticking between mid towards the rear of the pack. Definitely helps when you have a second commentator. I will tell you that now.
Do you need my CV? I'm unemployed now in TASCAR.
Well, this is a lucky circumstance that I was able to do streaming again for you guys. I don't know when it's going to be for the rest of December or possibly next year. And please reflip the table back when you're done, because table flipping is not a thing.
And Christian, you got food all over the place now. The fine china, really? You broke the china? Oh, come on, dude.
To be honest, you actually flipped over the fancy glass that was just imported specifically for this event, so thank you very much for destroying something that I'm going to have to pay for later.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Walmart, for sponsoring us and giving us this here glass.
Oh, man.
I take offense to that because I'm actually not going to say anything right now during the broadcast about personally with Walmart. So for now, I'm just going to say thank you for these 99-cent import glasses. The best you can find anywhere. Shucks.
For a low, low price.
Well, we've gone off topic for enough, so anybody else want to pass around the microphone? Because I'm tired of holding this damn thing.
Why is it sticky?
Oh.
Dude, we're live.
You would.
We are live.
You say that.
Professional.
Of all the people, man. Of all the people. And now this is recording.
Sorry, sometimes you can't let an opportunity like that slip by.
Yeah, about slipping.
The previous joke is brought to you by Tora's Holy Man.
You see what I have to deal with? All right, actually, no, this is an exclusive. You see what I have to deal with on Bowtie? Constant sexual harassment and stuff? That's why I'm leaving.
Wait,
I'm
well, no, 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 no,
no, no, no.
Not funny. No.
Stop it.
Stop. But, if you're going to do more commentary next year, yeah, I'll send you my CV. I mean, I won't be available all the time, but...
Well, if anything, I'll probably be asked to do tech next year. That's always a blast.
Don't worry, I won't say boogity, 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 let's go racing, boys.
I don't care.
I'm not that kind of driver.
I don't care if you want to be
handbook that is required.
I will make Larry McGrenner references now.
Do what you need to do.
Yeah.
Anyway.
All right. Well, looking at the clock here, I'm going to give us about 10 more minutes before I cut the plug. So feel free to discuss anything else. I'm going to cut it with a hacksaw.
Are you going to pull the plug?
No, I'm going to cut it.
We're going to pull the cord and
electrocute
myself.
I'm
going
to cut it.
Do it. I'm going to live stream it via webcam.
Awesome.
Lewis.
Yes.
Roger, roger.
Roger, Roger.
Who's this Roger fellow everybody keeps telling me about?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
Then why are we doing
it? Don't call me Shirley.
What are we doing?
Granted, I don't have any chips on my table, so.
All right, moving on to the next topic. 2017, what are you guys looking forward to?
Definitely looking forward to having a new, fresh face on board. That would be Big Groves himself. As tour people might have noticed, we gained a bunch of staff, or we added a bunch of staff recently, and Jordan was one of the new ones, and we'll see if we can get him in here and talk about his vision.
Is he even on right now?
He is. I invited him.
I will say this, there's a almost getting ready clause. To pass out.
There is a take-me-back clause that Mario has in place, because if Jordan adds the chase system, Mario will just immediately come back. He will literally bust out of his virtual grave.
No, please, let's not do the chase system. Please don't let us do the chase system.
Just no. We're not. No. We'll block that decision.
I gotta say that
veto.
Right now. There is no room for a playoff system in a motorsports.
Oh, definitely an event like this. No. Not possible.
Nope.
It'd be very small, if anything.
Yes, yes it would.
And it's significant.
If no one else has anything for regards to next year, best moments for this year, your worst, go for it.
Worst for me was the Daytona 500, I could definitely say that.
Mm-hmm.
Best moment for me was the Dewey T400. It was the same paint scheme I used today. It's based off of one of his old schemes that he ran in Forza 4. I believe in the Arca series when that was running.
I think that might have been one of his standard TASCAR paints.
Yeah,
I think so too.
Anyway, if you go on the forum, that paint scheme is his profile picture. So I decided to make an adaptation of it with my the Polk Audio sponsor, which, by the way, thank you to Polk Audio. You make really good headphones. Championship-winning headphones, by the way. Two-time championship-winning headphones, by the way.
Sponsor!
Sponsor plug. Shameless plug. Gotta get that money. But no, it was really good. And, you know, I joined the team right after he sadly passed away. I think a couple days right after, right? He sadly passed away.
It wasn't... I don't remember exactly when it was. It was a couple months after, actually, I think.
I think he passed away in April, and I joined in very, very late April.
Okay.
Yeah,
I don't remember exactly, but it was relatively soon.
Yeah, and, after. I heard a lot of stories, because at that point I was, getting to know everybody, and, they told me a lot about DVT, what he meant to the team. So when I heard that TASCAR was doing a memorial race, I felt that it was right to do that throwback paint scheme to honor him. And it was really cool when I just crossed the line and he came up to the final stint. It was an overtake I did on actually on Tower, who's in here, on the outside at Homestead on the final couple laps. And yeah, it was emotional for the team. I felt that, once I got that win, I really sort of told the team, hey, I did this for you guys, and let's try to get the bigger trophies down the line. So that was definitely one of the bigger moments of this TASCAR season. Actually, no, the biggest one was moment, honestly. Even bigger than this championship. Because honestly, that win honestly lifted AX4X up, on all grounds, whether it was TOR or DTCC. This year we were just doing a tally of championships, and everybody's been winning championships left and right. So, it feels good. It feels good. So,
yeah. And just to add to that for him, he made, and that was before I joined the team. So, there was no kind of favoritism at all toward him. Actually, I considered him my biggest nemesis on oval tracks, his fresh Cuban, and he made an absolutely just tremendously ballsy move around the I still don't know how he made the car stick around the outside on cold tires like that, but he did a fantastic pass for that win, and I didn't give him an inch. So, yeah. So congratulations on that. I know that was a big win for you, Cuban.
Yeah, and for the team in general.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And like I said, that was before I was a team member, so I didn't give him an inch to make that pass, and he still managed to hang it around the high side.
And Broom actually told me something funny, because I think, as we all know, Mikey J, Michael, he's not really much of a man of much emotion. If there's any emotion, it's mostly rage, so I'll never make him mad, but Broomski actually told me that he might actually cry if I actually won, and I never knew if he actually did or not. But
yeah,
that was a really cool one.
Anybody else?
Good.
I don't think
we can top that.
Yeah.
Mario, any management nightmares you had this season? Because there's always a dark side to every year.
Dealing with somebody that does not use a headset most of the time.
Mm. Yeah.
And well, actually, yeah. I think they know who they are.
Yeah, let's not name.
Well, actually,
I think I know who you talked about too, but I'm not gonna say any names.
I was gonna say, seeing how we're down here on the end of time, and this is Mark's last race. One particular memory from your time here with TORA.
Just one.
Your favorite one, worst one, whichever.
You basically have four. Oh,
boy.
Favorite story, what have you?
I guess my favorite story would have to be my very first TORA race. It was TORA GT season four, I want to believe. It might have been season three. I can't remember the dates properly. I joined TORA because someone on Forza Central was looking for teammates for the season. And I managed to qualify in the top lobby. At the time, the TORA GT was done on the track that had two variants, the short track and the full course. So qualifying set the sprint race. I ran a different gear package for the sprint race. It screwed me up to the point where I was in B lobby, mid B lobby actually, and the full course race. I took my time, got through the field, literally latched my car onto the back bumper of Selective Rogue, or his current tag is CQR Rogue, for a good 5 or 6 laps, I think it was. So he made a mistake coming out of turn one at Mugello and got by him, freaking just set sail for the rest of the race. Had a B my first race, I had a win. It wasn't an A-class win, but A-lobby win, but it was a win.
That's a story right there.
Yeah, we still got a couple more minutes.
And that was definitely more than 140 characters.
Message sent.
You forgot to say hashtag at the beginning of all that.
Yeah.
So start over.
No.
Well, you still have a couple more minutes to share some other stories, Mario. Anything else you want to pass around?
I'd say the first NATCC season, where Lewis and I took the team's championship.
That was a good one.
Yeah.
Speaking of Family Guy, I think I had a Stewie on my car, a different Stewie every single race.
Yes, you did.
Funny. I hate to cut it short, guys, but I got to get out of here, man. I got to get up at 4 a.m. and it's 8 now.
Yeah.
So,
and I've got dinner.
I just want to thank you for running
the
series,
Mario. Yeah, you
got to
go hit up that club bed with DJ Pillow.
Yeah. Yeah. Thanks for running the series, Mario. Best of luck to you in your endeavors. Thank you to everybody on AX4X, Flying Mikey J, Big Ben, Fresh Cuban Bread, Broomski, everybody that participated. And I had a blast and look forward to coming back next year to defend my Privateer Championship.
All right, Tower, and I'll make sure to add you to that Dolphins Facebook chat.
Yeah, man, go ahead and do that. I'm game. I'm into it.
Go fish.
All right, go fish. Y'all have a good evening, man, and we'll see y'all on the flip side.
All right, Tower, take care.
Thanks, Tower.
Right. Yep, later.
Yeah,
I'm starving.
I'm
heading out as well
because
MLS Cup is starting, and I like soccer, and I'm going to watch it. So, it was a really good year. Once again, Mario, thank you very much for running this shindig, and it was my first year, probably will be my only year. I'm not sure if I'm going to return anytime soon, but I have other things to tend to, and on top of with racing, probably management as well, but you'll probably hear a lot more about that in 2017. Hashtag follow at Team Gearhead on Twitter for more details.
Shameless plug, go.
Yeah, I already bought out, you know, Polk Audio. Championship winning headphones, by the way. So, gotta get that money, and also gotta get them signups for the thing I'm gonna do. The thing, which might happen, but a thing.
Can you be more cryptic?
Yes, I can be more cryptic. Cryptic.
Okay, could you be that's any cryptic. More vague?
So is it that
vague?
Let's go
vague.
Sent ya.
Well,
anyway,
just expect the unexpected.
I'm starving. See y'all later.
All right, Ben. Have a good one.
All right. Thank you, folks, for watching. I'm outie.
All righty. Catch you around. So does anybody else have to go?
I'm good.
You're always good. So, Lewis, will we ever see you back for commentary anytime soon?
Actually, you very well may.
Anything in particular that you should share with us, or is it all top secret?
Perhaps this, because everything else I'm pretty much going to be participating in with IndyCar in the Endurance Championship next year. So pretty much everything else I'm competing in. So unless you want to do some onboard in-car commentary, which, you know, that's always cool, but it can become a little bit R-rated with language anyway, depending on how frustrating it gets or what have you. So.
Well, that's why we have other onboard live streamers. They can entertain us for hours. Well, definitely looking forward to seeing you back in the comms booth soon, Lewis. Could always use some extra hands.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, definitely going to try and do it for TASCAR for every race that I can. I mean, today was just a special thing. I mean, anybody who knows me knows I'm not a big fan of NASCAR and not really keen on ovals or anything, but today was a special day to get one last ride here with Mario, and had to do it, so I'll put my differences aside just to go ahead and have one good last run with Mark there on that one. So,
well, definitely big thank you for coming in here and talking to us for a bit, goofing off, and having fun.
Yeah, that's pretty much all we were doing, was goofing off, wasn't it? Nobody told me we had to be serious.
I don't know. Sigh. And for you, Mario, anything you're looking forward to for next year, in case you pop into TORA?
Honestly, I don't know.
Mark, you're retired. I think you should enjoy your retirement for a little while, and then decide what you want to do.
Yeah, that's what I plan on doing.
There you go.
Try not thinking about it.
Well, if anything, you're welcome to come back at any time. And I'm sure more than anything.
Oh, I know.
Definitely people will be like, hey, come join us. We definitely have a spot for you. Alright, I should probably go see what my wife is doing because I heard noises. Maybe dishes, I don't know. Alright, time to put on the announcer voice. For all of us here at TASCAR and the Online Racing Association, this is AOW85, Straggler of the media team, alongside with Lewis Satterley and LMR DarthMario. Thank you very much, guys. This is the part where you can say goodbye.
Bye.
You forgot wind charger.
Wait, he's still here?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm still here.
We were waiting on that.
Okay, I'm watching a backdrop of one of the liveries I just downloaded on a Ford Fusion. I was so distracted by Brad Keselowski's livery here, even though it's not Rusty Wallace. Another topic for another time. So I'm going to give you an extra couple minutes, wind charger, since you've been quiet the entire time. What are you looking forward to this year?
IndyCar, the Endurance Championship, because that's pretty much all I'm going to be able to, and TASCAR next year, which is pretty much all I'm going to be able to do, working second shift. And then whatever I've got planned going on starting April, so. At least one series I'll be able to run the number one in.
And I probably asked this already. Anything you want to say to Mario, your sponsors, your friends, these people in the chat room?
I just want to say thank you, Mark, for making TASCAR what it is. I mean, honestly, without you, I mean, I don't think it would be as popular as it is. I mean,
just the entry list alone, this year is the biggest it's been. I think the biggest part of that was the NASCAR expansion pack that was announced.
Oh yeah. But it's been a rough year not being able to race at first, and then finally getting my Xbox One when I did. I was able to compete. I've done 3 races and then Touring Masters this year, so I've been take what I can get right now, and I'll be back next year. I don't know if I'll be back during the week, but I'll definitely be there on the weekends, running TEC, IndyCar, and all that stuff. So looking forward to it, and I'll say thank you to unofficial sponsor of mine. I just love them. I love Valvoline. I can't. They're on every car I run. Yeah, that's pretty much it.
All right, should I redo my outro?
I guess.
For all of us here at TASCAR and the Online Racing Association, this is AAA5, senior member of the TORA media team, because why not? Here with Radiation Lewis, LMR Darth Mario, and Windcharger 8199, who I just announced. Say goodbye, guys.
Goodbye. Bye, guys.
Bye. Bye, bye, bye. Bye.
All right, guys. Take care, and see you soon.